I'm Miss Anne, and I want to welcome you to Smart Start Virtual Stories Time from the Greenwood Public Library. Well, today we are going to do another letter that's kind of familiar. Scruffy, what do we have here? What do we have here? Scruffy, we have the letter what?
G!
G. Oh, look, it's such a pretty sparkling letter. But this G is a little different, isn't it? Sometimes G doesn't go g. It does j, like J sound, right? It's kind of crazy. All right, so Scruffy's going to put some things in his mouth that start with j. Ready? Giraffe. Did you guess giraffe? Oh, I think they're some of the most beautiful animals at the zoo. All right, here's one.
Gerbil. Gerbil.
Does anybody have a pet gerbil? Yeah, those are soft cuddling animals. All right, now this is the one. Ready?
Giant. Giant.
Did you guess giant? Yeah. All right. So that's when sometimes G is soft G. G, G. Right? Okay. If you have something for Scruffy, check your hand. Something good. All right, throw it high and wide. Ready? Go. All right, what do you tell the kids?
Thanks, guys!
All right. So now we're going to do a snippet of our Hagerty phonemic awareness. So we're going to do its rhyming time. So we put our thumbs up, we cross the midline, and we go, it's rhyming time, it's rhyming time. Ready? It's rhyming time, it's rhyming time, it's rhyming time. Oh, yeah. Rhyming words sound the same at the end. Yeah. All right. Put your thumbs up. Ready? Fox, box. How now? Ball, tall. All right, now we're going to do what's at the beginning. You go, oh, I don't know. Ready? What's at the beginning? What's at the beginning? I'm listening for the first sound you hear. All right, cross the midline. Look at my lips. Fox. Fox. All right. What letter? Put your front teeth on your bottom lip and you go, what letter makes that sound? F, right. Okay. Ready? Look at my mouth. Woman. Woman. Wah, wah, wah. What letter makes that wah sound? W, yeah. All right, here's another one. Cow. Cow. Right here. What letters? There's two letters that make that sound. C and K. All right, we're going to do K next week. All right, now we're going to do take two syllables, put them together. Ready? Take two syllables, put them together. Take two syllables, put them together. Here we go. Kit, ten. What do we got? Kitten. All right, the next one, Miss Emily. Oh, there's, okay. River. What'd you get? River, right. River, river. All right, last one. Oven. What'd you get? Oven. Let's do it. Oven. Oven. All right, so right now we're going to do a classic story, folktale. It's the Gingerbread Man. All right, so this is the thing we need to say in the middle of it. It's run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man. All right. Run, run as fast as you can. Say it. Run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. Say you can't catch me. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man. All right. So once upon a time, there was a little old man and a little old woman who lived in a little cottage near a river. Well, one afternoon they were really hungry for a snack, so the little old woman got busy. She got out her rolling pin and her flour and her eggs, and she rolled out some gingerbread dough and cut out a gingerbread man. And she put candy for eyes and a nose and a mouth, and she put him in the oven. Well, she waited probably about 25 minutes. And when the oven timer went off, she opened that oven door. But before she could take out the gingerbread man, he jumped out of the oven and said, "Don't eat me!" Well, the little old lady ran after that gingerbread man and she said, "Stop!" But he chanted, "Run, run as fast as you can." Ready? "Run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me." Say it real loud. "I'm the gingerbread man. I'm the gingerbread man." Well, so the gingerbread man, he ran into the garden and he met the little old man who yelled, "Stop! I want to eat you." But the gingerbread man ran even faster and he said, "I've run away from a little old woman, and I can run away from you too." Ready? Run, run as fast as you can. "Run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man." So the little old woman and the little old man were chasing him. And then he ran past the cat. And the cat said, "Stop. Meow. Stop. I want to eat you." But the gingerbread man was full speed ahead, and he said, "I've run away from the little old woman. I've run away from the little old man, and I can run away from you too. Run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man." Well, the cat joined the chase, and then the gingerbread man ran into the cow. And the cow said, "Moo, stop. I want to eat you." But the gingerbread man ran by him, and he said, "I've run away from a little old woman. I've run away from a little old man. I've run away from the cat, and I can run away from you too. Run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man." Well, now he came to the river, and he couldn't swim. And you know what happens to cookies if you dunk them in water. Like, have you ever tried to eat a cookie in the bathtub? No, it'll just disintegrate. Don't try it. So there was a fox, and he was a sly fox. So he didn't say, "Hey, I want to eat you." No, he said, "Hey, little fella, jump on my back, and I'll take you across the river." Well, the gingerbread man didn't have too much time to consider the possibility, since he had a line of hungry creatures that wanted to eat him. So he decided the safest option would be to stay on the fox's tail, the farthest away from his mouth. So they went across the river, and then the fox said, "You're too heavy. You need to jump on my back." So he jumped on his back. And then he said, "Oh, I'm starting to sink. You're too heavy. Jump on my nose." So he rode on his nose. And when they got to the shore, the fox snapped him in the air and he ate him up. And he was a very happy fox. And snip, snap, snap, my tale is told out. So that's the story of the gingerbread man. Now, Miss Lorianne has run off for you a very special book about the gingerbread man. Now, this book is a little different. Instead of having a cat, I think there's a horse that's in the chase, but it's to color. This is from BBC, and you can color it, and then you can have the gingerbread man jump out and run from page to page. It's really cute. And what I love about this is on this page, the oven opens up. Isn't that cool? So I wanted to show you. So I did mine and I colored it. So this is what you can do. And here's your little gingerbread man so you can retell the story, because retelling a story is really, really good. It's good for our brains, good for kindergarten preparation. Now, we also have another craft. I die cut some gingerbread shapes out of sandpaper, okay? And I put a magnet on the back so this can decorate your refrigerator. And then this is a cinnamon stick. And if you rub it and decorate it like this, oh, you smell that? Oh, it is so good. Then I have a little bow, and I've got some buttons and eyes, and your gingerbread guy might turn out like this. All right. Well, it was good to see you. So tune in next week. Bye-bye.